So this is take two. I've tried to do this video once and I don't know why it turned out so bad. So I was not able to put my point right now. So this video, I have all my videos, like thoughts collected. Hopefully I put my point straight. So that's the reason I'm refilming. So let's go take two or maybe take 100. Like if you see, technically it's take 100 because I had almost done the, I'm done talking. Let's go. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, we are going to talk about skincare. I'm so used to saying this word. We are going to talk about foods that trigger acne. And I'm sure if you follow me on Instagram, I've mentioned this 100 times that a couple of foods I avoid. And there's more to the list than the foods I just avoid. So I just thought I'll make a video about it because, man, I struggled with my skin and I wish back then, 5 years ago, 6 years ago, somebody told me that the food I was intaking was the main reason for my acne. My skin would have been so much better. Let's look at the types of acne. So there's one hormonal acne, there's two inflammation. If you're somebody who's suffering with hormonal acne, then you can not do anything topical. It has to be treated from inside your body. So you have to go see a dermatologist. They'll get various number of tests done. Their hormones are tested and then they give you certain medication and then only will your acne subside. Until then, because it's a problem internally, you know, nothing, even 10,000 cream on your face will not help if something inside is not right. One way to find out if your acne is hormonal is usually when you break out around this area. So usually if you break out around your chin area or jaw area, then that means you have hormonal, and it's usually like very cystic, like huge pimples which are very painful, and it take like a week or 10 days to, you know, come, like, and they stay and it's very painful. And so if it is that type of acne, then it is hormonal. You have to go see a dermatologist. You don't have any other option. Second is inflammation, and that is what we are going to talk about today, and that is the reason for my stupid acne. I have PCOD, okay, so my body cannot take a certain foods or anything of that sort which will alter my hormones in any way at all, because already our body has a lot of issues going on when you have PCOD, and you cannot like give anything which triggers it to, you know, make it worse. So let's start with the basic of why a person breaks out. So a person usually breaks out because of clogged pores, and usually clogged pores is because of the sebum content in your skin, or this excess amount of sebum. Why do you get a lot of sebum? It's usually because of the carbs you take.
So when we say carbs, we're talking about the bad carbs. There are good carbs and bad carbs, but we are talking about bad carbs in this video.
So let's look at why carbs, you know, affect your acne. When we take a lot of carbohydrates, our blood sugar level in the body goes high. Let's go into basic 10th class biology. When you take a lot of carbohydrates, your blood sugar level in your body goes up. That means, like, we know this, and we know all our diabetes patients around us, that, you know, their blood sugar level alters a lot. So that's the reason they have to keep their intake of carbs in check. Blood sugar level goes up, it produces insulin. When there's a lot of high amount of insulin in your body, insulin tends to make your body produce more androgen hormone. So androgen hormone usually controls the sebum production in your body, and then that clogs your pores, and hence you get acne. I hope that was simple and easy, like, to understand. If you're somebody whose body cannot take, like, is insulin resistant, or if you have PCOD, or if you have some sensitivity issue, then food is the major reason for your acne. So now that we've understood why we get acne, let's move into what all foods can cause acne. So let's start off with the most basic thing which a lot of people talk about is sugar. So what happens in sugar is, let's, you know, if you are not a person who knows anything about nutrition and you just know the generalized way of world is, you know, talks, then forget all, like, what you remember bachpan se. Now we are going to talk very practically and very much facts. Wow, my niche is improving very much every day. Anyway, so we have a lot of misconsumption of nutrition, like, you know, factual nutrition. So there's a lot of people who tell, like, I cannot eat fried food, I'll break out, you know, I cannot eat, like, that's too oily, I'll break out. That is very wrong, because trust me, this is the thing I've learned on keto. Keto was the best decision of my life. It was like my journey to, you know, healthier lifestyle. I'm so glad I was in keto. Anyway, so what happens, like, during keto, when you're on keto, you have to only take fat. You should cut out complete carbs, and you can only have like 20 grams of net carbs in one day. Okay. My skin during keto was so beautiful. My skin like repaired itself. It was so beautiful. It's so healthy, so glowy. You don't feel bloated at all when you're on keto because you don't take excessive carbs. Remember, oil will never cause you acne. If you want to prove, you know, get a proof, then just have like 2 spoons of coconut oil, 2 spoons of oil or olive oil. Maybe you will get fat, but you will never break out. Because remember, I just told you, carbohydrates increase blood level sugar, insulin, hormone, pimple. That's a misconception people have. Like when there's a tub of ice cream, people be like, oh, that's too much fat, don't eat that. But that is wrong, because that is actually not fat. If you eat that, you'll get fat. I guess that's the reason people call it fat. But that is high amount of carbohydrates. So it has sugar in it has milk in it, which has high amount of carbohydrates in it. So that's the reason when you take a lot of carbohydrates, your body doesn't break down a lot of it and it goes to, you know, store. And then that's the reason you put on weight and you get fat. There's a lot of playing with words which we have grown in. So we don't understand the basic difference between certain, you know, carbs, fat, fiber, like all those things. I don't think a lot of people do, unless you like, you know, try and search. And these are very basic things. One Google article, two Google articles, you try to understand, it's very basic. So coming to sugar. So sugar is a food item which has high amount of carbs. Everything. So if you get a breakout after a day or two after you had ice cream, milkshake, cake, chocolate, it is because of the sugar quantity in it. These are high amount of high carbohydrates. So that's the reason it'll affect your blood sugar levels, and again, hence acne. Everything is related to carbohydrate when it is inflammation, acne. And the second one is alcohol. I know we don't want to hear that alcohol makes us break out, but it is a fact, and it is like if you take it in a high amount. So I'll just read you one thing I have right here about why alcohol can make you break out. Drinking alcohol like wine, beer, liquor, etc. doesn't directly cause acne, but it causes a hormone domino effect that might. So drinking alcohol, especially when you drink to excess, can throw off your blood sugar level. When you mess with your blood sugar, you set off hormonal dominant effect that can cause acne. And studies show that drinking alcohol increases level of hormones, estrogen, and its metabolites, aka breakdown products. So again, like if you have some diabetes patients around you, you know, doctors suggest them to stop, you know, go off liquor or don't drink a lot of liquor, because it alters a lot with your blood sugar levels. So that's the reason again people get acne. Next one is wheat. When I say wheat, I mean gluten. There are a lot of people who have allergic reaction to gluten. They feel extremely bloated. They're like, it's very uncomfortable for them and whoever is gluten allergic. In India, since we have a lot of roti, all these have gluten. So we so commonly have roti that people, you know, neglect the thought that they might be, you know, allergic to gluten. This is a very common thing which comes to us, and a lot of people can identify it. I'm here talking generally about gluten allergy, and not a lot of people who have wheat will get acne. It's just that people who are allergic to gluten, you know, might. So the rest of the points, whatever I will cover in this video, you follow and still you break out. And if it is not hormonal acne you're suffering with and you still break out, probably wheat can be one of the reasons. Like probably gluten can be one of the reasons for your, you know, acne. And gluten, if you're gluten allergic, it is not only acne. There's a lot of discomfort people have. Like you always feel bloated. That's a different topic for another time. So next is dairy, my worst nightmare ever. And going off dairy is the best decision I did in my life. It changed my skin, and my skin is in the best condition it has been since 7 to 8 years. Like I started suffering with acne when I was in 8th standard. So whoever think my acne is because of makeup, shut up, okay? Because I've been suffering from acne since I was in 8th standard. That is, I was 14 years old and I got into makeup when I was 19 years old. So I've always been a person who suffered with acne, okay? So now that, you know, we are in quarantine, we are not even going out, like I don't even have cheese. Like I am guilty of having cheese, I cannot stay away. And it's more like in India, you don't have a lot of vegan, like not even vegan, dairy-free options. So it is difficult. Like if I want to have pizza, I have to have cheese, I don't have an option. And I love cheese. That's the one thing I'm trying to control. And even in my house right now, I don't have cheese, so my skin has been better than ever. There's a lot of argument that we have been having dairy since ages. Our parents have it, our mother, like everybody, our grandparents, so many had. everybody had diarrhea, but nobody had a reaction. But why is it now that we have a problem? The thing is, we are in a different generation, we are in a different age, we're in a different place where milk is produced in multiple different ways. So usually a cow or a buffalo, whichever animal gives milk, usually gives milk when they reproduce, when they have a baby. They usually produce milk to fulfill the needs of the baby. But what we do as humans to get a supply throughout the whole year, they're pumped, the animals are pumped with a lot, tons and tons of hormones to get the milk out, you know, like throughout this whole year, every single day. So the milk we get is pumped with a lot of hormones, so that can also put an effect on the hormones in your body, and hence you break out. And even if it is not the hormones, milk is a product, there is a product which has high carbs, so that could also be a reason. So there are two points. One could be the way the milk is produced, and one could be generally it's high in insulin, so you should stay away from it. Next comes eggs. So eggs also is the same point. Like if the hen or the eggs are grown organically, then it might not have any effect on your face. But if it is something again pumped and, you know, done in a various different ways, so that can also be the reason why, you know, you are allergic to egg and cannot have egg, because that could be a trigger for your acne. I cannot give an explanation other than that for eggs, because egg doesn't have carbs. Eggs are very low percentage of carbs. It has like 3 grams of carbs or anything. So I don't think eggs like puts off your blood sugar level in any way, but you know, it could be the way they're grown. So one more thing is caffeine. This was the most difficult thing for me to identify, that my body is not able to handle caffeine, because during when I went off sugar, off dairy, everything, there was one thing I always craved. It is Diet Coke. Like, it's Coke. Okay, so I had to do something because I'm not having sugar. I shifted to Diet Coke, and I used to have Diet Coke, and I used to not have anything else, which I am allergic to, but I still used to break out. I used to get a teeny tiny comedones type of acne. Realized that I get it when I'm having black coffee. I realize that when I'm having Diet Coke, etc. So Diet Coke has caffeine in it, so that's the reason it was making me break out, as well as black coffee has a lot of caffeine and it is making me break out. So the reason why caffeine makes you break out is, usually caffeine, people take caffeine to get a lot of energy, to get pumped and all those things. So when you intake caffeine, like you release a ton loads of stress hormones. So essentially that puts the adrenal glands into overdrive. I'm reading it out because I don't want to mess my words up and not explain to you properly. So that's the reason I'm reading out these parts. The high dosage of acidic caffeine in a regular cup of coffee triggers a stress response in the body, essentially putting the adrenal glands into overdrive, pumping out excessive amounts of stress hormones. The high amount of stress hormones coursing through your body can also mess up your normal blood sugar level by increasing the amount of insulin in the body. The excess insulin causes more oil to be produced, more equals more clogged pore, which means more acne. The high level of insulin produced from drinking coffee causes inflammation in the body. I rest my case. I hope you understood, because everything I explained was again re-explained, but it's in a different way. Like, so these are like kind of different ways how your body's blood sugar level can be, you know, altered and disturbed very easily. So you need to be mindful of that. And one last thing is makeup. Like, I personally don't believe it, but it is a fact that makeup can, this is not a food thing, but I wanted to put this point out there because I know people are gonna come for me if I don't. So makeup can cause acne, because only and only because you don't remove it properly, you don't exfoliate your face, you don't take care of your skin. So obviously when you're putting some external particle on your skin, it is your duty to again remove it properly and, you know, keep your skin nice and clean all the time. So I see that I don't personally believe it, because for me, my major acne is internal. The minute I have all these foods I mentioned, I do tend to break out. So the major things I avoid are sugar, dairy and caffeine, because these are three things which trigger my acne very quickly. Because I started becoming very picky about what I eat, people usually think I'm too uptight, I'm like high maintenance, or like, you know, why. I get it, but you know, I don't really care until and unless my skin is good. I don't care what people think, let them think what they want, because I want my skin to be healthy. It's okay if I don't eat a lot of food. It depends on a personal choice for everybody. If giving me a choice, food and good skin, I would any day choose good skin, but there might be people who would choose food, so that's a personal choice. For me personally, there could be 10 days I don't wear makeup and I still break out because of the food I eat, and there might be 10 days I wear makeup every single day for 5-6 hours and I eat clean and I don't break out. So my thought is that, because I do take care of my skin well post makeup, these are specific food items I've, you know, mentioned, because these are generally things which cause and trigger acne, but there are a lot of things which can alter your blood level sugar. So these are foods which are like high glycemic foods. Glycemic, I think that's how you pronounce it. I just put the caption or the word here. So basically high glycemic foods are like basically high carbohydrate foods. So that could be white rice, maida, or sugar, all dairy, all these are high carbohydrates food. So these come under that category. So you can substitute white rice with brown rice. You can substitute dairy with almond milk or soya milk. You can substitute sugar with stevia. So there are a lot of substitutes. You have to find your way. And like I don't eat sugar, but I do eat jaggery. What do you call it? We call it bellam in Telugu. So I do eat that sometimes occasionally. And one more thing is, when I say that all these foods are triggers, it doesn't mean like you have one sip of milk and you break out. It takes a certain quantity to affect your hormonal level. So it's not like I completely avoid all these things. I am guilty of certain times craving few things, but mostly I do stay away from these things. And if you're somebody who's tried a lot of things and you've not made a change in your diet, then probably you need to give a look into these things. And yeah, if it helps you, then let me know. And if you're somebody who already, you know, follows a certain diet or avoids certain foods which are acne, like, you know, acne triggers, and I've not mentioned them, then please comment in the comments below, because everybody is learning. I'm not a pro and I'm not here, you know, tell that I'm the know-it-all. I'm not a doctor. I'm here to just share my knowledge and help anybody who is suffering from acne, because my skin was a pain in my... Yeah. So do, you know, mention whatever is your triggers if you have anything, and so that other people will also know about it. And yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. And if you liked it, or if you think somebody who is suffering with acne needs to know it, then do share it. Maybe this would be a great, great help for them. And so if you like the video and if you think the video was useful, then make sure you hit the like button, share the video, you know, comment, like, subscribe. It will mean the world to me. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Come on.